Let's head over to a man who always enjoys his work, Chef Mark. And today, Mark, you've got the book Ripe Recipes, and we've also got the author. Gemma, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
So exciting.
I'm not the author.
You're not the... Wow.
No. What?
But you,
you're in here.
You're in there. That's all right.
Author
just
of
own
one
it.
Recipe.
Oh, yeah, there you go. And is that the one we're going to be making?
No.
We're going to do something
no,
else for the book?
Should be making this. It sounds awesome.
It's a bit tricky.
So oh, a bit tricky for TV. Okay, yeah. That's all right. But what are we going to be making today?
Today we're going to be doing smoky mumbo jumbo prawns, and with that we're going to do like a really nice slaw, but it's a sticky mango and avocado slaw, so it's lots of flavour.
Yum, sounds exciting, Mark, doesn't it?
Sounds like there's a lot of work to do, isn't it? Loads of ingredients out. You two are going
to
help.
That's right. I've been to the Ripe Deli before, and they know what they're doing, so I'm sure we're in good hands today.
Yep.
There's three of us in the kitchen. We'll get it. We'll get it sorted.
We'll
Don't
fine.
You worry about that. Well, we are in the Becco kitchen this morning with Gemma Heffernan from Ripe Deli, and we are cooking a recipe from the new book. So Mark's really good at cooking,
yeah.
So how about we get him underway and then going to ask you a couple of questions about the book. So what does he have to do first?
Okay, so we're doing the smoky mumbo jumbo prawns.
Yeah.
So basically this one's really easy. You've just got to chop everything up.
Okay.
So you're doing your garlic, your onions and your chorizo.
Okay, and how big do you want the chorizo?
Oh, just chunks.
Little cubies?
Chunks, no, not too fine.
Oh, okay,
we're all
good.
About rustic.
Mm, yeah,
you
okay,
know you
nice.
Want to taste it.
Nice.
So we're just going to chop it up and then we're going to put it in the fry pan.
Okay, good. I'm in charge of the fry pan today, Gemma.
Good.
Yeah? Do you trust me?
I don't know.
You put that worrying look
seen
on your face.
You cook.
Well, you're in for an experience, that's for sure. Okay, so
olive
nice
oil?
And rustic. Yes,
yep.
Okay, cool. How much would you like in?
A good dollop.
Yeah? Yep. Is that right?
That should be fine.
Okay, nice. So while Mark's cutting that up,
yep.
So this is Ripe Recipes,
yes.
A third helping,
a third
so obviously
helping.
Book number three.
Yeah.
How does it work? Is it all recipes from the Ripe Deli?
It is.
Okay,
yep.
Great.
So throughout the years, because Ripe has been around for 15 years now, so in 15 years there's three cookbooks. So this
brilliant.
Is the, and I think the last one was about 4 years ago.
Wow, okay.
So it's just really another era of Ripe cooking.
And how do you choose the recipes to put in it? Is it what's popular at the cafe or
yeah,
is it inspiring?
A lot of it is what's popular in the cafes, and then also it's kind of left to the chef that we have there and the bakers and their inspiration, because they're constantly coming up with new food ideas and flavours, so it's really all their effort.
Oh, yeah, nice. Yeah. And you've got a recipe in the book, haven't you?
Yeah, I do have a recipe in the book.
Nice.
Yep.
So are you, you're general manager of Ripe Deli at the moment, aren't you? So obviously you were cooking before you became GM.
Yeah.
Get in the kitchen much now?
Not often, only when someone's sick.
Oh,
is when
okay.
I'm going in there.
Do you love it?
I do. I miss it. I do love cooking, and I really love it when I go home now.
You didn't see that.
When did you give Mike a job?
No, I didn't know. Like the 2 second floor rule.
Yeah, it was
like
1 second.
Out.
What's that?
That one is the Cajun spice.
And straight in?
Yep, straight
okay,
in.
Okay, cool.
So this recipe is we went a year ago to LA and San Francisco.
Nutmeg?
That one is ground coriander.
Oh,
or
okay.
Might be either one.
Useless.
And I know that's
all right, let me guess. Cumin.
Yeah.
Yeah, or cumin. What is it?
Yeah, you're right.
Okay.
Well done.
Cumin. Cumin.
And this one? You're going to know this one.
Paprika?
Yes, very good.
Okay,
very
cool.
Good.
This is a fun game to play, isn't it?
And last one.
We should do this at your cafe.
You'll be here for a while.
Brown sugar?
It is.
Yay.
Great.
Okay. Right. Okay, so...
Yeah, so we went to LA and San Francisco a year ago, like me and Ange Redfern, who is the author of the book, who owns Ripe, and then our creative director, Amy Melchior. Whack it in.
Oh, great.
And we went to get inspiration, especially for our new shop that's opening next week in Smales Farm.
So this is a recipe from, inspired
from
the trip?
Yeah, this is from a Cuban place that we went to in San Francisco on Haight-Ashbury.
Is this for me, Mark, or is it in the recipe?
No, it's just half a glass for the recipe.
Okay, so half the beer in here?
Yes. No, it's the whole.
And the other half's for the chef.
Yeah. No,
and any particular
other,
beer?
That's the other five beers.
That's for the chef.
Okay, so you went looking, and I guess if you're looking around the world, you've got a lot of different places to go. Why particular that region?
Oh, well, they've always been quite amazing with food.
Oh, great.
Especially San Francisco.
I've never been there.
Well, you should.
Okay. It's a food hub, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's a fantastic city. I mean, it was hard to choose in the world where to go, but there was a place in LA that we really wanted to go to.
Nice.
Called Gusta, which was incredible.
Oh, wow. So, this is smelling incredible as well.
Yeah.
We'll find out more about the book in just a minute. Done as sort of mumbo over here.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to add the prawns soon, but we're just letting that reduce down.
Yep.
While we wait for that, Gemma, we're going to crack into the slaw.
Yeah, we're going to crack into the slaw. Now, this is really easy. It's just, it's quite a few ingredients, but you've just got to chop them up. So mm-hmm. Mark's just going to chop pretty much everything's just in chunks.
Nice.
And then we're going to toss it together and I'll make the dressing.
Oh, brilliant.
Which is really easy. In the cookbook it says use a stick blender, mm-hmm. but you can just use a bowl
use
and
a whisk
as well, because you're just mixing it.
Yeah, okay, cool. So we're going to start with some olive oil.
Just pour some of that in.
Yep.
And then we're going to add like a little bit of cider vinegar.
Okay.
Which we've got that.
Nice.
There. And then we've got to add, Mark's going to chop us up some parsley and coriander, but we'll mix these all together. And then we're going to add like a little bit of sweetness.
Yum.
Because it's going to be a little bit of tart with the vinegar, and we're going to add some fresh lime. So you need a little bit of sweetness to balance up the flavours.
Okay.
And then you've got that. And then we've also got some dried oregano, I think, in this one. Chuck it all in.
Nice.
And then we've got to zest our lime and lemon. Our lime, sorry.
Yeah.
And
we'll just get those.
Yeah, you want to?
Yeah, I can zest away.
Zest that up and I'll just whisk this all up together.
Which grape would you like?
Fine.
That one.
Oh yeah. Well, no, actually, no, that one.
Oh, you don't mind a little bit?
Yeah, because that one's real. If you use that one, I know.
Then wash that one, did you, mate? I'll give it a wee wash. You guys carry on.
I've never, you know that little tiny grate that's on a grater?
A microplane.
On the side of the home grater. It's like impossible to get anything out of.
That one. That's what you want to make him use.
Like,
Very
but see how that's
off.
Like thickening up and it's getting quite nice and, what is the word, emulsifying.
Emulsifying, yeah.
So you grate that in.
And when you're doing this, do you use the whole lime?
Yep, whole lime.
Oh, okay. Oh, that smells good,
doesn't
it?
Yeah, lime is
amazing. Watch your fingers, Mike.
How many recipes are in the book, do you know, Gemma?
Off by heart.
No, just how many in total?
I have a lot.
And who would enjoy this cookbook?
Oh, everyone.
Okay, great.
The whole thing is it aims for anyone. You know, there's lots and lots of salads and none of the recipes, apart from my cake, are that difficult. So this is...
But your cake looks awesome,
for a very special occasion.
Oh, I missed
but
a bit,
it's really
I?
Just aimed for anyone that loves food and for you to try and not be afraid of things. Anyone can create this at home to get lots of flavour and show off to your friends.
This looks fantastic. Thank you so much, Gemma.
Oh, you're welcome.
I can't wait to tuck into that. And thank you so much for bringing us a recipe from this awesome book, which is fantastic.
Yeah.
In good bookstores now.
It is.
And Mark, what are you going to be doing Monday?
Right, I'm joined by another chef, James Stapley, and we're making beetroot and galette.